Assalamualaikum. Selamat malam. Buat apa tu? Dah pukul 10 dah kan? So hari ni Ikin nak share a product review. New diffuser yang Ikin baru je dapat daripada US. Actually this diffuser ni dia tak jual dekat Malaysia. Tak jual kat Malaysia. Tapi Ikin Ikin dengan kawan-kawan kita orang nak juga diffuser ni, so kita orang beli dekat US. So not for sale this diffuser, but this diffuser ni dia tak jual kat Malaysia, tapi dia kita dapat this diffuser ni free if for new members yang join last January or February tu. So it's part of the loyalty program bulan yang ketujuh, which is supposedly last month lah, supposedly dia dah dapat lah. So this is the terracotta diffuser. Okay, Ikin. Hi Zulaika, thank you. Okay, Ikin nak cerita sikit kenapa nama dia terracotta. Siapa pernah dengar sejarah terracotta army in China? Okay. So, kalau yang living ni, kalau dia buat apa-apa je design, dia ada selalu ada meaning. That is one thing that I love about yang living new product. So, it's not just sekadar design, but there's a meaning behind it. Sometimes it's related to culture. So, for this terracotta diffuser, is very much related to culture, China culture. So, Ikin nak cerita about terracotta ni. So, terracotta ni, cerita dia, in 246 BCE stands for before common age. Before age of commerce, something like that lah. But it's a before century lah. So somewhere around 1700 centuries masa time tu. Lebih kurang lah kan. So there's one guy ni, among all the people, dia ni sangat brilliant, sangat smart. So his name is Yin Zhang. So this Yin Zhang ni, Dia somehow dapat menakluk satu state in China, which that state called Qin. So this Qin state, so after dia acquire that state, dia ambitious and he felt that he wants to make it better. So apa dia buat, dia pun menakluk all the neighboring state dekat China tu, dia combine kan, and dia lah yang menggabungkan all the whole China tu menjadikan satu country. So bila dia menggabungkan satu China ni, so he claim himself as emperor lah. So at that time, so waktu time dia jadi emperor tu, dia tukar nama dia jadi Qin Zhuangdi. Kau tak silap Ikin lah, Qin Zhuangdi macam tu. And at that time he was masa during dia punya jajahan tu, about 36 years of dia punya range tu, during that time tu yang China first introduce the fiscal system, maknanya sistem timbang, and then the one that standardize the tulisan across China, sebab dia nak standardizekan benda tu, timbang and then tulisan, standardized tulisan across China, sebab China pun macam kita tahu dia ada macam dialect macam kita kan. Dekat Malaysia kita pun ada macam Kelantan bahasa lain, ni bahasa lain, ni bahasa lain, but he needs a common language that can communicate with everyone. So masa time tu dia lah yang introducekan this script throughout China, standardized script throughout China, and he is the one yang memulakan pembinaan Great Wall of China, defense wall untuk China tu. Okay, so dia ni terlalu obsessed tau untuk mengekalkan dia punya legacy, dia punya history, and he is also obsessed tentang mortality, maknanya dia dia sebab dia rasa macam dia sangat berkuasa kan, so he don't want to macam jadi someone after life. So sebab dia punya idea is apa ni, they believe in karma, they believe in afterlife kan. So dia ni because of that obsess of that mortality punya obsessions tu, during that time tu dia start hantar rombongan keluar negara to find elixir of life. Maknanya mencari rahsia macam mana untuk kekal supaya dia tak mati. Of course benda tu is impossible kan. So after many explorations apa benda semua tu, he start to realize that okay, this is not going to succeed. But I'm not going to die alone. I'm going to bring the whole kingdom with me, ah, macam tu. So masa time tu dia dah start mengarahkan untuk buatkan siap-siap kalau dia nak mati tanam kat mana, and then dia nak ada the whole army with him, the whole istana dia tu yang padat dengan manusia tu ada dengan dia. And in fact masa time tu dia start buat dia punya what do you call carving for all the army tu. And then masa time diorang jumpa ni, yang first jumpa yang kira accidentally jumpa balik dia punya makam tu kan, was a farmer. Masa time tu dia jumpa satu telaga, bawah telaga tu was the terracotta emperor and the army, the whole thing. So they start to excavate lah penemuan makam ni masa time tu. That is during 1974, that's like it. So waktu tadi jumpa tu, they were so surprised sebab dekat bawah tu about 8,000 of army kat bawah tu. So ada makam, ada dia punya makam emperor, makam emperor Qin Shang Huangdi ni, and then the whole army is with him, and the whole army was in a battle formation. So dia ada macam pit-pit dia lah, sebab dia memang dah buat like macam istana kat bawah tanah tu kan. So dia ada macam few pit. So the first pit ada dalam 6,000 soldiers yang dia carve, and is a live sculpture of soldiers yang memang every soldiers are unique. Maknanya dia macam ada, macam bentuk muka sendiri apa benda semua. And masa time tu yang diorang start study, yang during that time yang baru diorang tahu macam oh, askar dia macam mana, macam mana rupa, because of that sculpture, that clay sculpture tu. Dia ada misai, dia ada macam goatee, lepas tu dia pakai topi. Nanti kita cerita tentang topi tu. Dia macam pakai topi, and dia pakai scarf macam Iki pakai ni. Dia macam pakai scarf macam ni. Alright, so diorang nampak lah macam mana rupa army at that time. So the first pit about 6,000 of soldiers, and then the second pit ada about 300 kereta kuda, dalam 130 kuda, and then the third pit is the higher commander, and then the fourth pit is the unfinished project. Dia tak sempat nak habiskan project tu. Diorang cakap actually the plan to have like the whole sculpture of the punya whole istana dekat bawah tu. Maknanya ada exotic animal, and then ada macam dia punya cook, dia punya writer, dia punya ballet dancer, apa benda semua tu. Dia nak buat benda tu, tapi benda tu tak complete. So imagine how big, how massive is the project is lah kan. So they believe they believe that this clay sculpture ni semua ni akan jadi dia punya peneman, sebab dia tak nak mati seorang. So dia nak ada kawan-kawan dia juga, ada dia nak rule a kingdom even though after dia after life. So that is dia punya purpose lah untuk adakan all this clay sculpture at that time. And masa tu that clay sculpture tu it has been said is diorang ada colour macam colour they paint it macam merah ke kuning ke macam tu lah, dia ada colour. Tapi throughout the time because kena matahari, so warna-warna ni pudar. So it just lay the terracotta punya warna tu, so warna clay tu lah. And then kalau kita tengok lah dia punya purpose tu kan, is the same purpose how Egypt during that time lah, Egypt, West Africa, and ada another few kingdom after this Qin punya dynasty ni kan, diorang pun ada macam buat clay macam ni juga. So the purpose is the same. Dia orang punya the purpose is to protect the emperor during afterlife macam tu. So the design, okay, mesh ini kita nak unbox eh. So the terracotta design ni is inspired daripada cerita ni, cerita dia. So itu tunjukkan apa yang makna meaning terracotta tu, dekat mana design terracotta tu. Okay, so jom kita buka eh. Iki pun tak buka lagi sebenarnya. This thing. So this is how the box is. This is how the box is. It comes with the manual. It comes with the manual. Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. So kita tarik keluar. And then, okay, so ni dia the box kat dalam, dekat dalam ni lah. Okay. The box yang kat dalam ni. So let's open. Let's open ni. I'm so excited to see. Wow, you see this? So dia ada dengan plastik, dengan the box. And I have, okay, so dia ada, it comes with the adapter. Sorry, adapter lah. Dia punya plug kan. Tapi because my version is coming from US. So the plug ni, I have to use yang universal punya plug untuk convert dia punya ni. But I have Kinito. This one, this Kinito ni is a mobile. So I will see later on whether that I boleh plug in ke tak. So kalau boleh plug in, then I will try to macam switch it on, because I have my distilled water with me and racks of EO dekat depan I, so I can choose. Actually for US punya set ni, it comes with Ecuadorian Ecuadorian lemongrass. Tapi I'm not going to talk about this because I will make a special session untuk this one. So it comes together with these essential oils for US punya market. Right, so let's see. Nampak tak? Okay. So why nama dia terracotta? So the inspirations from that terracotta comes from that terracotta army itulah. So you see. Okay, so the design is a clay. This is clay design, right? And then, you see, this is the punya cover. So we can put water kat dalam ni. So this is the level of water. And of course, the ultrasonic punya design, ultrasonic plate ada kat dalam ni. All yang living punya diffuser comes with the ultrasonic plate. So that helps to even disperse or pecahkan lagi the molecules of essential oils tu. And dia ada bamboo punya ni. Alright, so how terracotta punya inspirations in this design. So one is the material made from clay. And you see tak, the top ni dia macam ni tau. So terracotta army, dia punya cerita, dia punya, depending on the ranking. Tapi cara dia sama. Lower rank of officer or army, they're using like a wool cap. Dia macam pakai cap, wool cap macam tu. Tapi dia ada macam, ada macam hujung dia macam ni, ada bonjol macam ni. Dia ada bonjol macam ni. So dia pakai macam ni, bonjol dia macam ni. So dia macam pakai cap macam tu. Alright, so if you see, dia punya kepala dia macam ni. Dia ada macam ni kan. So imagine lah kalau macam kepala, topi dia macam tu. Tek, dia ada macam coet macam tu kan. So that is dia punya design lah kat sini. That is one of dia punya design. Material is from clay. And the top design from dia punya topi tu. Even the higher lagi ranking army dia, dia tak pakai topi, tapi dia pakai dia dandankan rambut dia with braids. Tapi diikat, and diikat pun dekat position yang sama. So dia punya cara dia pun sama juga, ke tepi macam tu juga. And then they have scarf. They use scarf. Dia punya terracotta army tu dia pakai scarf. That is so called to protect the neck. To protect the neck. So you see the bamboo ni. So imagine like the bamboo ni macam represent the scarf lah macam tu. So dia signifies. So that's the meaning design behind terracotta terracotta diffuser, which is signifies the terracotta army tadi yang kita cerita tadi itulah. Okay, so dia sangat cantik tau. Nampak tak dia punya carving ni? So it is very like looks very masculine. So nampak eksklusif kan? Okay, so I'm not sure sebab this one is from US. So the plug ni macam I tak boleh nak pakai this one. But I will try with my mobile punya plug ni. So this is Kinito, right? So I let me see kalau boleh masuk. So mana dia punya ni eh? Ah, okay. So dia punya tombol yang untuk masukkan dia punya plug ni kat belakang ni. So let me see if I can plug in. Yay, boleh masuk. Hi Zaid. Okay, yay, boleh masuk. Okay, right, nice. Let's see. Okay, so lagi satu dia ada lampu tau. Dia ada lampu kat bawah ni. Dia ada lampu. Cantik kan? So dia boleh tukar-tukar warna juga. Tara. Okay. Lights dekat sini. Lights dia. Nampak tak dia tukar warna? Kuning tak nampak sangat lah. Hijau lah, hijau dia cantik. Biru dan putih. Okay, so I have this distilled water with me. So let's see. So I felt like diffusing, even though this one come together from US, Ecuadorian lemongrass. But I tak nak buka dulu. I will tell specifically one session just about this. So hari ni Ikin rasa Ikin nak diffuse What L Heaven. Suka sangat bau dia. Okay, jom kita tengok macam mana. Right, so kita letak air. Dia ada water level kat dalam ni. So we just put on. Okay, and then nampak tak? Right. So Ikin nak tunjukkan dia punya, ada tak nampak dia punya button. Okay, dia punya button. Nampak kan? Dia punya button tu. Okay. Tak stable lah dia punya ni. Okay. So kita tutupkan dia. Oh, so cantik. Okay, let's switch on. Alah, Ikin punya bateri tak ni lah. Aduh, sedih lah. Sekejap. Tengah mencari how I can my ni tak cukup charger ke. Aduh, sedih case pun. Alah, tak cukup charger. Sekejap kena pinjam how ni punya. Sebab I tak ada that converter tu. So let's see if I can do this. Okay, let's see. Jom kita try. Boleh tak? Tak cukup kuat lah Ikin punya charger ni. Ikin punya Kinito ni. Aduh, sedih kes betul. Tapi nak ikut dia punya asap dia, patut keluar kat sini lah. Tapi Ikin punya Kinito ni, dia punya ni tak cukup bateri kan. My fault lah, I tak charge tadi. Aduh, sedih kes. Okay, so but at least I already tell the story behind terracotta diffuser and what make it so special. So cantik kan dia punya ni. Itulah. So Ikin suka sangat design dia. This is ada lagi satu clay diffuser called Heaven Diffuser. Yang tu insyaAllah nanti Ikin akan buat juga review untuk yang tu. But today is terracotta diffuser. So siapa yang dapat free hari tu, congratulations for all you guys yang dapat free. Because this is a special diffuser yang memang tak jual kat Malaysia kan. Sedih. Congratulations for those yang dapat free. That apa ni, under that loyalty program kan. Okay, so if you guys have apa ni, anything to ask regarding this topic, you can drop me a comment. If you love my video sharing, bagi encouragement sikit kat Kim, like and share my post, and then hopefully we can get more people and then create more awareness on why we love Young Living products. Okay, alright, thank you so much guys. Good night and have a good rest. Bye.